Hi there and welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're talking about sums and products. Now the skill we're going to encounter in this video is going to be something that's super useful for all our work on quadratics, so that's why we're doing it, even though at the outset it mightn't look like it's got anything to do with quadratics. Let's begin by introducing the idea. Something you already know, here's two questions for you. What's the sum of 2 and 5? What's the product of 2 and 5? Well, sum means to add the numbers. The sum of 2 and 5 is going to be 2, add 5 is 7. And the product of 2 and 5 is 2 multiplied by 5, which is 10. Very easy. Now let me show you the type of puzzle I'm going to ask you in this video. I'm going to go backwards and say, can you find two integers whose sum is 7 and whose product is 10? Now just before we go on, do you remember what integers are? Well, integers mean whole numbers. They can be positive or negative. Okay. Now we know the answer to this from above. Two numbers that sum to 7 and have a product of 10 are going to be 2 and 5, aren't they, from above? And there only are one pair of numbers that do that. Okay. So that's the type of puzzle we're going to try and solve in this particular video. So I'm going to start by giving you one to think about yourself. Please pause the video and have a go and see if you can come up with how to do it yourself without being shown. Find two integers whose sum is 13 and product is 40. Okay, what did you do? Well, I'm going to show you what I would do. If you started by thinking of numbers that sum to 13, you're going to be in a bad place. Let me show you why. Loads of things sum to 13. 13 add 0, 12 add 1, 11 add 2, and you can see the pattern going on. You could even say 14 add negative 1. 15 add negative 2, they all sum to 13. In fact, there are infinitely many combinations of numbers that sum to 13. So by starting off by trying to find the two numbers that do that and have a product of 40, you're in the wrong game really, because you'll be there all day. What you want to do is find two integers that have a product of 40, i.e. you are just listing the factors of 40. The factors of 40 are 1 multiplied by 40, 2 multiplied by 20, 4 multiplied by 10, 5 multiplied by 8, and they are all of them. So once you've listed out these, and there are only a certain number, there are a finite amount, you can look at these and go, well, which of these also sum up to 13? That doesn't, that doesn't, that doesn't. Oh yeah, 5 and 8 do, so they're my numbers. So the two integers here are 5 and 8, because 5 add 8 is 13, 5 multiplied by 8 is 40, and you're done. So tip for you, think of the numbers that make the product first before you think of which ones make the sum. Right, now I think you're ready to go. Do pause at each stage, try each question before I show you the answer. Pause, have a go. Right. Sum of 7 and product of 12. I think of 12 and I think, well, it's 1 multiplied by 12, it's 2 multiplied by 6, and it's 3 multiplied by 4. Okay? And I think any of those have a sum of 7? Yep, 3 and 4. So my numbers are 3 and 4, positive 3 and positive 4. What about a sum of 1 and a product of negative 12? Well, the numbers that multiply to negative 12, okay, they are like the ones that multiplied to positive 12, other than one of them's got to be a negative. So you've just got to think, right, it's one of these combinations here. How can I sum these numbers up to get a 1? By one of them being negative and the other one being positive. Well, I can see that, look, if I choose, let's say, positive 4 and negative 3, positive 4 multiplied by negative 3 is certainly negative 12, because a positive multiplied by negative is negative. But also, positive 4 add negative 3 is going to be positive 1. So that's how I know what they are in that case. What about the next one? Well, in this case, I'm thinking, I know it's a combination of these here, but one has to be negative, one's positive, to get a product of negative. So I'm thinking negative 4 and 3 will do the trick. Negative 4 multiplied by positive 3 is negative 12. Negative 4 add positive 3 is negative 1. And the last ones, well, to get myself a product that's positive, I either have to have two positives multiplying and two negatives multiplying. I know it's going to be two negatives because the numbers have to sum up to negative 7. And what works? Well, negative 4 and negative 3 do the trick. Negative 4 multiplied by negative 3 is positive 12. Negative 4 add negative 3 is negative 7. I've got the numbers. pause the video, have a go at the following. Okay, we're looking for two integers whose sum is 5 and product is 6. Just going to write down the factors of 6, 1 multiplied by 6 and 2 multiplied by 3. Okay, can we think of, are any of these two sum up to 5 as well? Yeah, 2 and 3. So our numbers are 2 and 3 because 2 multiplied by 3 is 6, 2 add 3 is 5. Done. Next one, whose sum is 6 and product is 5? I just swapped the 5 and the 6 round. Right, what multiplies to 5? Only 1 multiplied by 5, isn't it? Because 5 is actually a prime number. And 5 and 1 also add to 6. Hey presto, our numbers are 1 and 5. 1 multiplied by 5 is 5. 1 add 5 is 6. Got them. Next one. Well, we need a product of 5 here. Right, we need a product of 5 here and a sum of negative 6. Now we know that what multiplies to 5 is 1 and 5, but we want a sum of negative 6. So how about if we had negative 1 multiplied by negative 5? Negative 1 multiplied by negative 5 is positive 5, and negative 1 add negative 5 gives me the sum negative 6. So the numbers here, negative 1 and negative 5, will do the trick just fine. Last one, sum is negative 1 and product is negative 6. Let's just write what multiplies to 6. 1 and 6 and 2 and 3. From any of these, where 1's going to be positive and 1's going to be negative, to get a product that's a negative answer, can I get a sum of negative 1? Yeah, well, if I pick positive 2 and negative 3, that'll do the trick, because 2 multiplied by negative 3 is negative 6. 2 add negative 3 is negative 1, and I'm done. Next set, pause and have a go. Find two integers whose sum is 0 and product is negative 9. Let's just write the factors of 9 first. It's 1 and 9 and 3 and 3. Could any of these in any combination sum up to 0? Yeah, they could. 3, and if I chose that one of these to be negative 3. And so my numbers are going to be 3, negative 3 and 3. Let's just double check why. Negative 3 multiplied by 3 is negative 9, and negative multiplied by positives overall gives me, that's the only way I can get a negative number as a product, but negative 3 add positive 3 is 0. And you can see that the numbers are going to be the same in this case, but just different signs. It's the only way for them to sum to 0 and have a negative product. So here I'm sure you can see the answers must be negative 4 and 4. Here I'm sure you can see it must be negative 1 and 1, and here it must be negative 12 and 12. Just double check one at random. Why? Well, negative 1 multiplied by positive 1 is negative 1, and negative 1 add 1 is 0. It's the only numbers that would work for. Next ones. Right, we're looking for a product of 1 and a sum of 2. The only things that multiply to 1 if they're integers are 1 and 1, and look, they nicely add up to 2, so 1 and 1. A product of 4 and a sum of 4. Well, what multiplies to 4? 1 multiplied by 4 and 2 multiplied by 2. Well, the only ones that add up to 4 as well would be 2 and 2. Okay? Sum of 6 and a product of 9. Well, the things that multiply to 9, 1 multiplied by 9 and 3 multiplied by 3. And look, 3 and 3 sum up to 6. Sum is 10, product is 25. Well, the factors of 25 are 1 multiplied by 25 and 5 multiplied by 5. And 5 and 5 sum up to 10. So in this case, I just wanted to show you sometimes it's a repeated number, because here 1 and 1 sum to 2 but multiplied to 1. Here 3 and 3 sum to 6 but I had a product of 9. So sometimes it can be the same number as well. Last pair for you to have a go at. Okay, two integers whose sum is 5 and product is negative 84. When I see big numbers like that, I'm not going to write all the factors of 84, because I could be there all day. I just think, in my times tables, what do I know multiplies to 84? Well, I know 7 and 12 do. Okay, that's how 84 is in my times tables, the easiest way I can think of. And in order to multiply to negative 84, one of these has to be negative. So it's either negative 7 multiplied by 12, or it's going to be 7 multiplied by negative 12. Now, do any of these pairs have a sum of 5? Yeah, they do. 12 and negative 7. So 12 and negative 7, if I multiply them, negative 84. If I add them, positive 5. Done. Same thing here. Now, 130 is outside my times tables. When they're big numbers like that, just think of obvious things that you know multiplied to 130. I know for sure 13 and 10 do. Right? I just try the easiest option first because usually that comes out as the answer. And in order for them to multiply to negative 130, either it's negative 13 multiplied by positive 10 or 13 multiplied by negative 10. And in any combination of this, do they sum to negative 3? Yep, negative 13 add positive 10 is negative 3. So my answers are negative 13 and positive 10. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.